For Habitat Earth, our new show for the Morrison Planetarium, one of my jobs was to animate all the living creatures in the show. So we see sea otters and ants and fish, a lot of birds, and my job was to animate them and try to make them look as realistic and lifelike as possible. When we build these animals for the show, we start with a lot of reference. For instance, for a couple of the shots, we're here in Oakland Middle Harbor Shoreline Park, and so we went out and shot reference to see what kind of birds were out there. For the sea otter, I went down to Monterey to actually check out some real sea otters for myself. Then, really early in the process, we check in with the scientists here at the Academy to make sure that we're on the right track before we go too far down the road. With the birds, as an example, we met with Jack Dumbacher, the head of ornithology and mammalogy here at the Academy of Sciences. We told him, you know, we're thinking of doing a scene here at this time of year, and these are the birds that we expect to be there. And we double-checked with him, and he said, yeah, these birds would be migrating. These ones would be in their breeding plumage. And so we kind of assembled our cast of characters from there. And then it's a matter of building the 3D models. We utilize some of the collections here at the Academy whenever we can. And the sea otter is a great example of that. We were able to take a sea otter skull that's in our collections and do a 3D scan of it to build a 3D model. And then I use that as sort of the infrastructure for building the actual skin of the otter. I kind of layered that with photographs and used that to mold it. It's kind of a sculpting process. And then after we built it, you have this 3D model, but you kind of need to give it clothes, or a texture is what we call it. Again, we went into the collections. We have all these sea otter pelts here at the Academy. And we went in, we took photographs of it, and I was able to use those photographs to basically paint on the texture of the sea otter. Next, you need to make it ready for animation. We call it rigging, one of my favorite parts, actually. And what you're essentially doing is building an animatable skeleton within the animal and giving it controls that you can animate easily. And it's really fun because it's kind of like you're building a robot in the computer. The sea otter was really challenging in that way because their bodies are so fluid and those smooth curves and they're so quick. That one was pretty challenging versus something like the ant, for instance, which the movements are a little bit more robotic. For the birds, it took a lot of research because just from looking at them, you might not understand the bones that are in a bird's wing and how they all function or what their different rotations are. And so I did some research and talked to some people here at the Academy and found out exactly how birds fly. And that helps in building the rig because you got to get all the rotations right if you want it to look really accurate and not just like it's swimming through the air. After we get the rigging done, then you're ready for animation. It's like puppeteering in a way, just inside a computer. You have all these animation controls that you can manipulate to pose the animal in different ways to get that natural movement. We work as a team. And let's take the kelp forest, for instance. Matt Blackwell was doing a ton of work building this beautiful kelp forest environment. And meanwhile, I would be in a separate program animating the sea otter. And then I would give it over to Matt, and he would then integrate it into his scene so that all the lighting could properly function on the sea otter. Because it's such a recognizable and kind of charismatic creature that we really wanted the audience to connect with, it was important to get it right. I kind of learned and got better as we went. I'd like to keep moving forward with it and see how we can continue to get more interest out of these specimens or whatever it is here at the Academy to teach people and to inspire people to come here and actually see the real thing, because there's nothing beats the real thing.